Companies have been making a lot of promises lately.
We're going to reduce our carbon footprint to net zero.
Unilever is committing to net zero emissions.
We can achieve a net zero emissions world.
But what does net zero actually mean? At the most basic level, net zero means not putting any more carbon into the atmosphere than you're taking out. Climate scientists say the whole world needs to get there by 2050 if we want to avoid the worst consequences of climate change. And the companies that make all of our stuff are a key part of that. So how can you tell if a net zero pledge has substance beyond the beautiful shots of wind turbines? Let's look at two hypothetical car companies with net zero plans to see the difference. This is the Falcon car company. Falcon plans to power all of its factories and its offices with renewable energy. There's still some sources of emissions from their factories that they aren't sure they can clean up, like the super hot furnaces they use to build car parts. To make up for that, the company says they'll pay to plant some trees. Sounds like a pretty solid plan, right? Well, this plan will only clean up about 5% of the carbon emissions tied to Falcon's business. It doesn't address the fact that their main product runs on fossil fuels. That brings us to the Sparrow car company. They also say they're going net zero, but they're looking at it in a completely different way. Just like Falcon, Sparrow is cleaning up all their direct emissions and buying clean energy. But Sparrow is also looking at indirect emissions, known as Scope 3 emissions. That includes the carbon footprint of the materials they use to make their cars, the cars themselves, and everything in between. Under this net zero plan, Sparrow will need to use more recycled materials, they'll need to produce more efficient vehicles, and eventually, they'll stop producing gas-powered cars altogether. And they'll also pressure suppliers to cut their emissions too. Otherwise, they'll be forced to take their business elsewhere. This is the power of tackling Scope 3 emissions. One company's climate plan can ripple out across the whole economy. Still, it might not be possible for companies like Sparrow to eliminate all of their emissions by 2050. That means Sparrow will need to invest in ways to suck carbon back up and store it, so that no new carbon accumulates in the atmosphere. So the next time you see a company with a net zero plan, remember to read between the lines for these key details. Does their plan include all of their emissions? Will they actually cut emissions, or are they just planning to buy carbon offsets? Do they have near-term goals? We can't wait until 2049 to figure this out. And finally, can you trust their numbers? There are organizations that vet corporate climate plans and can tell you if they're legit. Like it or not, we need companies to go net zero. But if they say they'll do it, we've got to hold them accountable.